The list of tasks started or completed in just the last week or two is significant, and each one is singularly focused on similar goals. Pave the way for SpaceX to finish testing the first orbital-class Starship and Super Heavy booster, and prepare for the first orbital launch attempt of the largest rocket ever built. Launch tower kicking off a jam-packed 2 weeks of minor to major finishing touches. SpaceX has moved Starbase's rocket-catching chopstick arms, for the first time, since they were installed on the orbital Starship pad's launch tower, 2 months ago. After a shockingly brisk 3-month period of assembly, the first arm installed in late August 2021 was a lone structure designed to swing in, grab and stabilize Super Heavy with its claw, fuel and power Starship, and quickly detach and swing away from the rocket during launch. A month and a half later, SpaceX began installing a much larger pair of more complex arms in mid-October. Unlike the Starship quick disconnect arm, the pair of arms that followed were almost nothing like anything built as part of another rocket launch complex. Unlike other arms related to other rocket launch facilities, the pair SpaceX began to install on Starbase's launch tower were colossal, measuring more than 30 meters, 100 plus ft long and 5 to 10 meters tall. Built out of heavy-duty steel pipe and affixed to an even sturdier pair of claw-like supports that grab onto the launch tower, the combined assembly likely weighs hundreds of tons. Aside from their sheer scale, Starbase's main tower arms are also attached to a complex system of cables and an industrial-strength drawworks, commonly used on giant oil rigs and derricks. They also feature huge actuators that allow the two arms to open and close, revealing a bit of their purpose. While the main reason they likely exist is to provide SpaceX with an all-weather alternative to cranes for lifting, manipulating, and precisely stacking Starships and Super Heavy boosters at the launch pad. The headline, ever since Musk revealed the idea, has always been plans to use those same arms to literally catch rockets out of midair. To do so, they'll need to be able to actuate and move extremely quickly and precisely up and down the Starship launch tower. Matching the velocity and autonomously determining the position of landing Super Heavy boosters, and possibly Starships, to avoid major damage or the loss of entire vehicles. While arguably an unnecessary gamble and an attempt to micro-optimize the concept of operations of a rocket that's yet to attempt a single orbital-class launch, SpaceX's CEO is clearly committed to the idea and, whether or not the first iteration works, has fully delivered on the first complete lift-and-catch system. On January 3, 2022, after removing a large amount of scaffolding in the days prior, SpaceX briefly and slightly moved the installed arms for the first time, using the drawworks to lift the entire arm and carry an assembly a few meters, approximately 6 feet up and down the tower. Once a few minor additional steps are taken, the chopsticks could be ready for much more extensive testing, beginning with basic lift, descent, and arm actuation tests to calibrate and then proof the first-of-its-kind mechanism. Later, SpaceX will likely simulate catching rockets in a wide range of scenarios. Somewhere before, during, or after the testing, SpaceX may perform another fit test with Starship S-20 and Super Heavy B-4, but this time using the arms to lift and install the stages. In the near future, those arms will be used to grab, lift, and install Super Heavy boosters and stack Starships on top of them. While SpaceX also hopes to eventually use them to catch boosters and ships out of midair. At least for the former role, a separate arm visible about halfway up the tower in the photo above will also be crucial. Known as the tower's Starship quick disconnect arm or claw, SpaceX has also made significant progress on the structure, practically completing it in the last few days. Designed to fuel Starship and stabilize the top of Super Heavy with its claw, the Starship QD arm is also able to swing left and right both to quickly back away during launches and to make room for the catch arms during rocket catches and ship booster stacking operations. Last week, SpaceX technicians finished plumbing the arm, which requires thousands of feet of insulated steel tubes to connect to the pad's propellant tanks. This week, SpaceX installed the last major component of the arm, the actual quick disconnect QD mechanism that will connect to Starship to supply power, communications, and propellant. A few small actuators likely still need to be installed, and the QD mechanism itself will have to be fully connected to pad systems, but the QD arm now appears to be more or less complete, and should soon be ready to fuel Starships installed on top of Super Heavy boosters. SpaceX's latest plan to increase the number of flights they can mount by drastically reducing turnaround time. The key to this was a new launch tower that would catch first stage boosters after they return to Earth. This would forego the need to install landing legs on future Super Heavy boosters, and potentially future Starship returning to Earth. Musk shared this idea in response to a tweet made by an animator, who goes by the Twitter handle ERCX, who asked if his latest render of a Starship landing next to its launch tower was accurate. As usual, Musk responded via Twitter, saying, "We're going to try to catch the Super Heavy booster with the launch tower arm, using the grid fins to take the load, saves mass and cost of legs and enables immediate repositioning of booster, onto launch mount, ready to refly in under an hour." So Musk is promising a turnaround time of less than 1 hour now and has confirmed that future Starships will be retrievable using this same apparatus and others like it. This latter scenario is likely to occur if and when Starships begin taking passengers on point-to-point flights between major cities, a service that Musk has promised will be available once the Starship is cleared for commercial flights. In the same thread, Musk was asked if such a structure would ever be built on Mars, and if Super Heavy boosters might be built there for missions to the outer solar system. "Yes, on both counts. That would be a great outcome for civilization," replied Musk. It has since been rejoined by Ship 20, which has performed several static fire tests, culminating in firing all six of its Raptor engines, a first for any Starship and the current record for most Raptor engines fired at once. Ship 20 now resides on suborbital Pad B Booster 4, meanwhile, had aerodynamic covers attached and several engines swapped. It was lifted back onto the now nearly complete orbital pad, for a third time in December, where it performed cryogenic proofing. It has recently been removed from the orbital launch mount. With the FAA citing its plans to issue the final programmatic environmental assessment for the SpaceX Starship Super Heavy project no earlier than the end of February. SpaceX can claim the review process is the schedule driver. However, Booster 4 has yet to conduct a static fire test, likely including an eventual full 29-engine firing. SpaceX's Starship program is set to take its next leap in the coming year, following a 2022 that included numerous test flights and wide-scale groundwork at its launch and production facilities. For now, it's almost impossible to say when Starship S-20 and Super Heavy B-4 will be ready for their orbital launch debut, as that now lies almost solely in the hands of the FAA. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.